Hi there, my name is Christina Halsted, and this is a brief tutorial on how to use the brush and color tools for Toon Boom Harmony Essentials. First thing I'll talk about is the brush. It's this symbol right here, it's a little paintbrush. Basically what you're doing is you're creating a fill of a certain width. It is pressure sensitive, which is pretty nice, and it'll obviously do whatever color you have selected in your palette. You can have pressure sensitivity attached to this, so if you actually, in your tool property, you can actually open up this little arrow right here, and what it will do is it will bring up this brush properties. And what you can do here is you can tell the maximum minimum size of the brush itself. Minimum basically means how wide the tip will be as a percentage of the actual full width. So if you want a very narrow tip, obviously 0% is as thin as it'll get. 100% means no matter how hard you push with your tablet pen, it's always going to be the same width throughout the brush. I usually keep mine somewhere between 10 and 30. So you get a nice little tip to your drawing. You also have smoothing, which, much like the pencil tool, the higher the smooth, the more straight your line will be. You can see it kind of altered the line there. So it'll straighten it out. It's more pronounced with the brush tool than it is with the pencil tool. So I usually keep that. And unless you're super shaky, you generally don't need to have it up too high to get the kind of line you want. Of course, preferences are up to you. You can change the tip size right here, the tip shape. So you can have pretty self-explanatory. Usually most people just keep it round. I think they have all sorts of fun little shapes. You got stars down here if you want kind of a textured, almost brush-like tip. And you can even get little spots in there. Which makes a real interesting shape, actually. And what's interesting is this is actually a shape you can mess with. And what I just picked up there was actually the contour tool. And let me zoom out a little bit, so you can see. I'm going to select all these with the select tool and delete them, just so I can clear up my space here. And I'm going to go back to regular tip. So basically, when you use the brush tool, you're making a contour, basically a filled area. And if you use the white arrow, which is the contour line, you can actually go in and alter the shape, because you're pulling at the contour points. The difference between this and the brush tool, of course, is that the brush tool has one single line, or the pencil tool has one single line in the middle, whereas the brush tool, the line is all around the outside. To change the color, you simply pick the color in the palette that you want. You can always change the color by selecting with the select tool and tapping the colors, which makes it really easy. So if you decide you didn't like that color, you can just pick another color easily without having to redraw the line. You can also go into, if you want to make a new color and then change the color of that, you can actually double tap on the swatch itself, and you can see that the line is actually going to change color at the same time. It's actively pulling that color, so you can always change on the fly. Of course, right here is where you can go to name your color swatch. So that's the brush tool. The color tools, basically the fill tools like the paint bucket, those, you have a couple settings within that little drop down. First of them is paint. So let's say I'll draw a black line here. It makes, you can see that I have stroke activated, which is that thin blue line right there. And that lets me know that I can actually see where the contour, where the edges of the line are. So with that settled, I can go into my paint bucket and pick a color, and it'll just automatically fill that area so long as the contour line is closed. If I want to unpaint that, I can pick the paint bucket with the negative sign, and that takes away the color. It'll also do that for the line work, so you have to be careful where you go. another, see, before I show you the paint unpainted, I'll show you how the stroke works. So basically this little kind of half circle right here, squiggly line, is the stroke tool. You need to have your show stroke activated so you can actually see it. Otherwise, you'll get a warning saying that you can't actually see what you just did. So if I go ahead and draw, you'll see it makes a line. It's almost like the pencil tool in that it produces a line, but it doesn't add a color to that line. You're not actively putting down any kind of visible color. And once you have that drawn, you can actually go in with the contour editor, just like the pencil, and change the shape and move it around. Now, as you can see, it's incomplete. So another helpful tool is what's called closed gap. It looks just like the stroke tool, but it has a straight line. And basically, you can kind of draw near the area you want to close, and you'll see that it'll close it for you. And with these, the blue dots mean that it is actually a closed area, and that these two lines are actually touching. A yellow dot means that it's not touching anything. So I can go ahead and pull that, and you can see that this yellow dot is not attached to anything. A helpful way of getting rid of these is a tool in the select dropdown called the cutter. I can just draw across that, and it'll actually delete that from the rest of the line work. It usually looks for a cross point. The computer kind of computes where it's going to cut from there. And if you don't want it to cut like that, you'll have to go kind of deeper into the drawing and choose where it's going to do that. So now that I have a complete closed box, I can go into... Actually, I'm going to do one more thing, and I'm going to draw a line across this to show how paint unpainted works. And so they have those extra lines there. I'll go ahead and clean that up with the cutter tool and kind of cut across it and erase those two. So what I'll do here is I will now paint this right here. So let's say I want to go ahead and paint this green. But if I have the paint bucket selected, circling this will select and make everything green. This handy feature right here is the paint unpainted. If I circle the same area with that selected, it will only fill in the parts of the contour line that have no color previously in it. So that's kind of helpful if you're working on a character, and let's say they have a design on a shirt where you've already filled in the shirt and you just want to real quickly get the rest of those design marks in there and colored without selecting the shirt. And I'll explain that a little bit later when going into working on an actual character. So that's basically how you do the brushwork and the paint bucket.